What food is overrated? Activated charcoal, anything. The only reason should ever be eating activated charcoal is if you've got gas. Or have overdosed on something, in a medical environment. That shit can really fuck with your meds and food. It is technically a detoxifier. But turns out there's a good reason why chemists don't stock that stuff in the wellness section. Edit, this includes toothpaste. But for a different reason, it's like sandpaper for your teeth. Yes, it whitens them. But it also strips the enamel off them. Shark fin soup. Apparently it tastes bland and has little nutritional value. Poor sharks getting slaughtered for this. I used to shark fish in my younger days. I no longer do it for ethical reasons. I've had shark fin soup. The fin gives no flavor. It just makes the broth gelatinous. You can get the same results from cornstarch. Gold-covered anything is a waste of money and the definition of superfluous excess, since it doesn't add flavor and wastes the gold. Wastes the gold? In 1,000 years, when all the gold has been panned out of Alaskan streams, future panners will still have a source of gold in our ancient shit rivers. They'll probably market it as rare archaeological privy gold and charge accordingly. Fondant. If that counts. I see all these fancy cakes in bakeries and on TV shows, and my first thought is 90% of that is just sugary Play-Doh. The cake boss makes cakes that are 80% Rice Krispie and 10% fondant. I'm not sure how what he makes can be called cakes. But they look good. Any burger that is too big to pick up and bite. If I have to dismantle it. It's not a burger. Edit, so my top rated comment is about stupidly large burgers. Amazing. Burger makers of the world. Pay attention, Reddit has spoken. They should be wider, not taller. Gold flakes. It don't even taste good. To add to that. I stopped watching those world's most expensive, insert food item here, when it was just like a scoop of good ice cream with a diamond in it and gold flake on top. Like. That's not the world's most expensive. It's just a good ice cream with a diamond on it. I'm just here to defend cheese. Tacos. Fried pickles. Open thread. Control plus F garlic bread. Zero results. I'm proud of you. Reddit. Meowmix for sure. Dude, Meowmix is delicious. Even if it doesn't contain cats like on the packaging. Kinda a scam. But still tasty. Those red berries on bushes in parks. They taste like burning. The $2,000 steak. $10,000 burger. $1,000 cocktail. All that overly priced bullshit. Totally overrated. Bacon flavored infused anything. Don't get me wrong. I love a couple of rashers as much as the next man. But come on. Bacon fat washed whiskey? Fat washing with something like bacon, coconut or butter won't change the taste all too much. But it will alter the texture and make your bourbon smoother and less aggressive to the palate. But bacon everything needs to stop. This isn't 2012 internet anymore. Anything that Salt Bae touches. Fuck that guy. I'll tell you what's not, Message. Message is fucking amazing. Frappuccinos from Starbucks? It's $6 for a cup of ice and artificial sweeteners and sugars. I treat it like ice cream or a milkshake. It's not coffee, it's a dessert. The little packets in beef jerky that say do not eat. You have to microwave them first. The McRib. It's good, but I don't get why people go nuts over it. Artificial scarcity. McDonald's only buys pork when it's cheap enough. So the McRib only shows up once in a while. Food is subjective, but in general caviar is very overrated just because it's associated with luxury. Really anything associated with luxury like champagne or oysters I find a bit overrated. Edit, to stop the same comment over and over again, oysters are expensive anywhere, they aren't common. If you live by the coast and you comment how but they're like $1 here, that's because. Surprise surprise. You live by the coast. Seafood doesn't travel well, so it gets expensive the further you have to ship it. I tried caviar for the first time a few months ago. Always thought it was an overpriced luxury good that rich people use to flaunt their wealth. Unfortunately. I loved it. It's really good. I'll definitely use it in the future to flaunt my not being totally broke. Those Instagrammable burgers. Burritos. ETC. That are all covered in melted cheese. Don't cover things with liquid cheese. Drink it. Card. Activated charcoal to color food. It's really unhealthy. No flavor and overrated. For those asking, activated charcoal messes with a lot of medications in weird ways. So if you're on any medications, it's recommended you stay away from it. As a side, activated charcoal in toothpaste is known to turn certain fillings black, which could end up requiring expensive dental work to redo fillings. Edit, spelling. It's not quite a rule. But for many restaurants, if it has a view, the food is terrible. As an example, cafes near the Eiffel Tower are generally bad. Tourist traps. Overpriced and unimaginative offerings. French food is so much more than that. But a trip to Paris is so overwhelming. Tourists don't always find the truly great meals. And instead go home thinking that little cafe found when your feet were tired from walking back from seeing the sights is somehow representative of the entire cuisine. Pretty sure that little cafe is specifically there because that's about where people putter out. Turkish delight. I would know. I am a Turk. I've wanted to try one ever since I saw the first Narnia movie. They look so good. But IDK if that's actually how they are, lol. Jack Links and Matador Beef Jerky. Like 15 years ago they had actual selections of beef jerky, now it's like two trashy brands that taste like shit. Gas stations have better beef jerky for sale than stores. Wild Bill's so good. I feel like I need to shop for beef jerky online like my parents did for me as a kid and get it in like a huge bundle of beef jerky. Fuck me sideways. I love Wild Bill's jerky. Every jerky I've eaten has paled in comparison. I remember 10 years ago my dad sent me some while I was deployed to Afghanistan. I ate a little and left the rest in a desk I shared with a friend. Came back the next day and night shift found it and ate it all. I almost cried. Caviar. Which is funny because it started off as poor people food and like everything else the rich took it and made it a status symbol. Russian fishermen learned to farm caviar as early as the 12th century and for centuries it was considered nothing more than cheap peasant food. Served with porridge and eaten by the bellful. However, once Ivan the Terrible got a taste for it, its status changed and it has remained a delicacy since. It's funny because salmon roe is still really popular among regular people in Russia. Especially on New Year's. The expensive black caviar isn't as popular for sure though. But I much more prefer the taste of salmon roe anyways. I have it often on top of bread with some tea at breakfast. Fucking fondant. You disgusting fondant lovers. Use buttercream like a person with functional taster buds. I love fondant cakes. It's so much easier to keep to my diet when I know the dessert is gross. Name brand beef jerky. I've only ever had homemade jerky from my days of cooking classes and a local guy selling them at breweries and festivals. Bought whatever popular brand of jerky they sell in bulk for a road trip and barely ate one piece. Gave the rest to the panhandler by my work. That stuff was too damn sweet to the point it was inedible to me. I'll stick to my local jerk. Deleted. Gourmet donuts. Oh look, your donut was dipped in cereal. Wait in line for the experience and that'll be $5 please for one donut. The cost and the trendiness does not make a superior product. Hand cut fries. I don't care if you cut them fresh daily if you don't know how to blanch. Fry. Salt that shit properly, it just tastes like newspaper. Yellow crayons. Red are the best and it's not even close. Found a marine in the wild. My very sweet. Retired nurse. Mother has an unfounded hatred for tiramisu. I think a 90s trend of it being the dessert is the cause. We love to bring up how delicious it is and let her start on a rant. Who wants soggy biscuits with a side of cocoa powder up your nostrils? Better than sex whatever. Do you eat the mascara? Purina bacon strips. Made with real bacon my ass. Tastes nothing like bacon. Sashimi of live toads to increase libido.